The International Monetary Fund cut its growth forecasts for China and the Eurozone. The IMF now expecting China economy to grow 5% in 2023, down from its previous estimate of 5.2%. It also slashed its growth forecast for China for 2024 from 4.5% to now at 4.2%. The IMF attributes this to China's property crisis and weak external demand. As for the Eurozone, the IMF sees its economy growing 0.7% in 2023 from its July forecast of 0.9%. For 2024, economic growth in the region is projected to slow from its previous estimate of 1.5% to just 1.2%. Overall, the IMF left its global growth forecast unchanged in 3% in 2023, but it cuts its 2024 forecast from 3 to 2.9%. That's as it said, concerns linger over volatile commodity prices, geopolitical fragmentation, and a resurgence of inflation. The latest in Israel as clashes there enter the fourth day. Two Filipinos now confirmed to have died from the conflict. The Philippine embassy in Israel said the two were killed by Hamas militants near the Gaza border when they infiltrated Israel. The embassy has informed the families of the victims who have requested to keep their identities private. The embassy is also verifying a possible third Filipino fatality. Meanwhile, three more Filipinos remain unaccounted for. Philippine authorities are not recommending a mandatory repatriation of Filipinos from Israel as the situation there has considerably improved.
The embassy has not recommended it because mandatory repatriation or alert level 4 is called when the country has broken down, when the rule of law and everything about peace and order has broken down. That is not the case in the state of Israel. The two killings occurred because of the attack last Saturday, and the situation has turned to a certain semblance of normalcy.
As much as we would like to immediately extend assistance to our kababayan in conflict areas, the embassy must adhere to the strict travel restrictions enforced by Israeli authorities in these areas. However, the Israeli government assures us that during emergency situations, Israeli security authorities and the Home Front Command have established protocols for evacuating anyone who is in Israel, regardless of nationality.
Humanitarian group Doctors Without Borders urging the Middle Eastern country to proceed cautiously in its response to the violence there. Speaking to ANC, the group said a humanitarian crisis is quickly unfolding in the country with medical supplies running thin very fast. More than 1,000 people have now been killed in Israel, while over 900 more are dead in Gaza.
Scale of violence is just profoundly shocking. This is on a scale that we've never witnessed, but the intensity of the bombing currently in Gaza is making it almost impossible for people to move. It's very hard for us to get critical patients moved from one place to another because ambulances are also being targeted. There's a number of hospital facilities that have been directly bombed and damaged during the last 3-4 days. Yeah, so we, like many others, are calling on Israel to measure its response. One thing, of course, is a proportional response to the threat Israel finds itself under. But another is treating the entire population of Gaza as if they were all combatants, a complete siege that will impact all 2 million inhabitants. And you have to understand, half of those inhabitants are children, is completely unacceptable. There has to be a way to get emergency supplies, food, water, fuel, and of course, medical supplies and personnel in. Otherwise, we will not be able to prevent a catastrophe.
We continue to monitor the movement of global oil prices as the Israel-Hamas conflict rages on. Oil futures are up this Wednesday as investors grapple with the prospect of supply disruptions from the turmoil in the Middle East. On Tuesday, top oil exporter Saudi Arabia said it is ramping up efforts to prevent an escalation of the situation in Gaza. It also reaffirmed its support to stabilize the oil markets. Taking a look at oil futures, Brent crude is poised to trade at $88 per barrel, while West Texas could trade at $86 a barrel.
Now, Manila's finance chief urges reforms and increased concessionality in the financing models of multilateral development banks to address ongoing global challenges. Finance Secretary Benjamin Diokno made that pitch during the G24 ministerial meeting at the annual gathering of the World Bank and the International Monetary Fund in Morocco. Secretary Diokno welcomed proposed measures that could further increase the financing capacity of MDBs. The finance chief suggested that MDBs make better financing terms available amid rising interest rates and increasing costs of international borrowing. The body subsequently approved the G24 communique on reforming the financial models and terms of MDBs, as well as promoting durable debt resolution measures to address debt distress.